Have you kept the wolf from the door, or is it full time for Halfwit? To the 10th eviction of 2009. Now, before I speak to the House, I just wanted to let you know that this morning, Halfwit received a special prize from Big Brother, and that was his original name of Freddie. So Halfwit is no more. It's Freddie from now on. So Freddie and Marcus think that they know what's about to happen. Marcus will go and Freddie will stay. Will the results are in, and we're about to find out if they're right. I'm now going to talk to the House. Big Brother House, this is Davina. You are live on Channel 4. Please do not swear. Freddie.
Yes.
And Marcus.
Hello, that's me.
The lines are closed, the votes have been counted and verified, and I can now reveal that the 10th person to be evicted from the Big Brother House is.
Let's see.
No. Oh.
Freddie! Oh,
yeah. Lovely to meet you guys.
Rock and roll.
What a game of old cack.
Oh.
Bring on the rest of
Freddie,
the summer.
Freddie, it's now time for you to say your goodbyes. I'm coming to get you!
Oh.
Don't say too much bad about me, will you?
No, mate, rock and roll.
Oh, what
a lovely to meet you, B.
You too, take care.
Will do. Oh, Charlie. God,
you little pimple foxy. Oh,
nice. Careful. See you later, kid.
This has been
bring your brother,
the most incredible fun
in my life.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Sorry, mate.
Freddie, you have been evicted.
See you soon, yeah?
Please leave the Big Brother house.
Freddie,
you have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house.
See you, Vash, my man.
Freddie, you have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house.
See all of you.
See ya.
Good luck.
Bye.
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 Bye, Freddie.
See you later, Freddie. See ya.
Mwah.
Goodbye, guys. Rock and fucking roll.
Let's go.
Earlier today, yes. You are now Freddie, but I got so used to you being Halfwit.
Yeah, I did
as
well.
How does it feel having Freddie back?
It's kind of funny. Like, in a way, I feel myself again. It's appropriate having it coming out of the house, you know?
Yes, and you've been reborn.
Indeed, I have.
Yeah. As a Freddie. Now, listen, I know that you expected to stay tonight. You mm-hmm. have voiced that this week.
Yes.
Were you shocked tonight?
No, I don't know. I think I went astray in a lot of the last few weeks at the house. I wasn't
in what
that
way?
Surprised. Huh?
In what way?
I got dragged out of myself a bit. I was spending a lot of time trying to help other people in the house in a bit of a misguided way. Mm. Well, that's how it felt to me anyway.
Freddie, I can't quite believe you've got a purple cat face.
Yes.
There must be. Oh, it's a fox.
Yes.
I haven't met many purple foxes.
It's Tania's own Foxy Frederick.
Foxy Frederick.
Yes.
Of course, I should have known. Judy, now listen, Judy. Why do you think Freddie is sat here tonight and not Marcus?
I can't analyse a foxy face, sorry.
Yes, I know, it's hard, isn't it?
I mean, one thing was that, like a lot of politicians, you made a lot of fatal assumptions about why people were voting for you.
Okay.
I mean, I had the feeling that you kind of suddenly, perhaps to do with Hera, the fact that she was a bit quieter, and I think maybe you learnt the lesson that you needed to be a bit more active in the house, but that wasn't really the you that we loved. And what that meant was that Marcus, who started off as the bad guy, kind of got a bit softer and a bit sweeter and a bit nicer. He showed his slightly more...
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, his nicer side.
And Lisa noticed
that. And you were almost going in the opposite direction.
Opposite, yeah.
So, I mean, a few weeks ago, this just would not have been imaginable. It's just really the last week or so.
John, were you a Freddie fan?
Well, I was a Freddie fan, but Freddie, public school boys don't blub. Public schoolboys don't have panic. They don't have panic attacks.
No, he was having a bad time.
No, seriously, you don't go and blub. You went to public school. You were
birthday. It's all right for men to cry.
No, it is not. No,
it's okay.
No. You let yourself down by doing that. The public voted for you as a favourite.
You can't say that. You can't say that.
Yeah, fine.
You were not in the situation. It's so intense.
Listen, let's just talk about that intense situation because it is actually about you and B. You and B had a very, very big roller coaster of a ride in there.
You really
let's,
did.
Let's just have a quick look at that.
Yeah.
Let's have a quick look at that.
B is fantastic. There's someone here that, you know, I really fancy and have a real connection with.
He's just got an overwhelmingly genuine vibe and really sweet, and that's just a warmth that you get off him. Well, hopefully we'll be here together for a while.
Hopefully indeed.
Freddie likes you.
I'm not interested in Freddie. Oh, everywhere I turn, Freddie's there.
You going for a cigarette?
I am, yeah, with Thea Vash. Just feel a bit claustrophobic.
Stop causing trouble. Stop looking for it and stop causing it.
All right, done. Freddie is an absolute fucking tool at the moment. He's acting like a prize noddy. You know, I'm not a violent person. If I was outside of here, I'd give him a slap.
Oh, B.
I find you negative. I deal with negative people all the same.
Oh, no.
I try to get as far away from them as I can. Everyone's going to be like, oh, poor Freddie, poor Freddie. Oh, shit, look at Freddie. Oh, God, what has B said to him?
Oh, God.
Well done.
Thank you.
I've upset him, and he is going to milk it for all that it's worth.
Negative little man.
I did not say that.
You did say it, and it's all on fucking camera.
The plan is to make me look as unpleasant and nasty as possible. Totally classless little rude, arrogant idiot.
Freddie, what happened? What happened to you and B? It was so weird. Out of nowhere, it just all went catastrophically wrong. What's your take on that?
I don't know. My take on it is I had a few different views. One thing I thought was it was... It basically turned into a situation where she was blaming me for all of the negativity she was feeling in the house. Mm. And it was getting loaded on really heavily to
you
me.
You were quite physically close to her, though. You really...
Yeah.
You wanted her badly.
It was puppy love, wasn't it?
It was puppy love
to stop. Yes, it was.
Yeah,
you were falling all over. You couldn't
believe... You know when somebody... when you don't fancy someone back, I think that's when it started. She
but she egged him on.
She did egg him on, you're right.
You've got to also understand that, like, I'm in that situation, you go with the emotion of it. It's part of the Big Brother experience.
Yes. Yes.
So, yes, I was allowing myself to go to that place, and she was doing whatever she was doing, but it wasn't like... Do you know what I mean? I don't feel like... It didn't feel like rejection at the end. It just felt like... God, she's just being so nasty.
But she was doing what Norrin did to you as well. Norrin was exactly the same. She played you the same way.
B is the new Norrin.
Exactly, she is.
B is the new Norrin.
Absolutely. Listen, you were playing twice. Judy, and you blubbed.
Judy, oh, get over that, please. Judy, Freddie fancies himself as an armchair psychologist.
I'm a romantic.
What did you make of him?
I mean, this for me was your Greek tragedy, Freddie, because you have so many good qualities.
Yes.
You're quite a modest guy, but then you have this thing with hubris and pride, which is about your ability to read people. And I hope that you've learnt in the house that you're not that good at reading people.
Really?
I mean, another one, your ingratiation techniques were not very good.
Okay.
I mean, you had a lot of trouble bonding with people at the start. Your body language and reading people skills, definitely you need a bit more work on that.
Okay.
And I have to say that Sophie was actually a lot more adept at reading people. She was a lot more accurate than you were. So I think in a way that was almost your downfall. You made assumptions about that as well.
But
Go on.
No, but you did overcome being a toff, which was true. The public voted you in so much time, a toff,
also,
and they kept on voting for you.
Toff's normally out straight away.
I know. And
posh
we had,
voice,
and,
out.
And we had Kenny in there boasting
so
about his wealth, boasting about his security guards and everything. You hardly ever mention your little pile. What's it like, your little pile?
So, listen, I want to know what your analysis is of Judy's analysis. Do you think that's fair? You find it hard to... You're not as good at reading people as you think?
I think with the B situation, that's definitely... Yeah, that's definitely true. I did see... she did enjoy cuddling me.
Oh.
Yeah, she did enjoy herself. And I never thought that she was really, really into me. I let the emotion go with it.
Come on, you did a bit.
No, but you think, the thing is, when you're in the house and, you know that it's not real, but you enjoy the emotion of it anyway...
Mm.
And that's it, really. But you're right, though, about reading it. I didn't see this nasty side. I saw that she was bitchy and nasty and stuff, but you always think that you're the exception.
Yeah, you saw her bitching about other people.
Why couldn't you take it, though? Why did it get you down so badly?
But it was like chipping away, wasn't it?
Yeah, it built up over time. I gradually got pulled more and more out of myself and more stressed about it. You know, it was really intense, actually.
Listen, now, Judy, you think that Freddie's time in the house could be sort of split up into three important chapters. First was when he first went in. So let's chat about that.
Yeah, it's like a game of three parts for you, Freddie.
Yes.
I mean, when you first went in, one of the techniques, why you kept getting put up for eviction each week, you were actually over-congruent in your niceness. And I know that sounds crazy, but when you were doing all the sort of hippie Freddie thing, people... get an animal response to that, which is it makes them feel quite fearful. Why is this guy masking what might be his true personality? Does he mean us harm? Is he being sarcastic?
Yeah.
And that means that they didn't trust you for those first few weeks.
Okay.
And I think neither did the public to a certain extent.
And then a very important moment happened 5 weeks in. So let's have a quick look at that.
Siavash said what he said from a place of helping you, of being honest with
How's
you.
How's that helping me when that's
you.
Lies? Like,
and
it's
like,
not helping me.
You know,
it's helping
Noreen,
me the truth.
People have been saying
if
things
it's the
about
truth.
You.
Like who? Have you been saying
and
something about
you
me?
Have repaid him.
How?
By this spectacle.
You weren't
I
there.
I wasn't there for the exact moment when he said those names, which I would have guessed.
Honestly, that was such a funny moment. Talk us through that.
That was the turning point. That was when you stood up to Noreen, and I think everybody saw another side of you. People then thought, oh, no, we can actually trust this nice person that we've seen. You became Freddie the Defender at that
Freddie
stage.
Freddie the Defender.
And everybody, they kind of saw you, funnily enough, as father of the house at that stage.
Mm.
And I don't know if you remember, but there was a certain point when it was Sophie and Roddy were actually asking you to sing them lullabies.
I
you
do,
became
yeah.
like their daddy, so everybody felt very safe with you, very trusting with you.
And then we reached the third and final phase. Mm. Let's have a look at that.
Okay. Nana, Lisa's up for eviction.
And you are, Frederick.
Yeah, I know.
Can I have my face?
But I'm staying.
You're trying to warm me up.
Because the public like me. They've kept me in. They've had lots of opportunities to get rid of me.
Oh, I don't know why they've got it so wrong.
Huh?
Got it so wrong. You're such a knob.
Yeah.
From day one, you're one I wouldn't mix with on the outside, trust me.
Oh, my God.
And then because we're friends.
See why I laugh now,
because people...
See why
Lisa. Because people... Lisa.
You two are so happy. Well, we've been doing well, and it's not that. Yeah. I mean, at the end of the day... Oh, you're such
Big
a prick.
Brother,
you are such a prick. You are such a little prick.
I mean, so what about that?
Unfortunately, this was the new phase and you started attacking people in the house. Mm. I mean, I could understand it, but unfortunately it kind of confirmed their first fears over those first few weeks. It's as though you've been sitting on all of that and you suddenly decided to let it all out.
It seems so unlike him as well.
Well, it was passive-aggressive, you know. I mean, you know what that means. You know, it's like
what does it mean, though?
Well,
just
it's
quickly.
As though you've been quite submissive but sitting on a load of resentment and then suddenly turning feral. And that, again, makes people feel very very unsafe with you, so they felt very threatened again at that point.
And there's always prejudice too against what people perceive as the upper class twit. That's
right.
How you perceive it from the outside and from the inside. I think you did a lot to overcome it.
Yes. Mm.
And you did show that you were a reasonable human being. I'm going to say no more than that. And even you've got weaknesses and everything like that. But being a toff isn't easy. Mm. Lucky I'm not, of course. I only went to Harrow, so I'm not a toff. It isn't easy.
As a toff in my book.
But, you know, the Tories are coming, the toffs are back. You want to be in politics, and you're the kind of person who's going to rule us in the years to come.
Yeah.
Well, that's the arrogance.
He
assumes...
He looks like a fox.
Yeah, but you've not had a vote yet, as far as the public are concerned, and yet you assume you're going to rule
us.
Freddie
from the Foxy Party.
We'll see.
Freddie, what do you think of Judy's comments there about your journey in the house?
In the third phase, I was being pulled very much in two separate directions and out of myself. Marcus was becoming more socially isolated, and I was being pulled towards him because I really didn't want him to be isolated. B was having a stressful time in the house, and that was one reason why I was drawn towards her with such tenderness in the first place. I really wanted to be positive for B, and I really wanted to be solid and rock and roll with
you
Marcus.
You came over as a puppy lover.
But listen,
that's what
sorry,
over
John,
as.
Hold on one second.
Yeah.
Now, listen, now that you've gone, who would you like to win?
Siobhan!
No, don't listen to what they're saying. I want to think, who do you like
who would you
from
vote
living
for?
In the house?
Don't say
no,
I don't
not.
Think he'll say B. I'm not sure about that.
My favourite people still in the house are Marcus, Siavash, and Rodrigo.
Those are your three faves.
Yes, definitely.
Johnny!
And who do you think will win?
My money's going on Sophie. Actually, I think there's a lot more of her to come.
When she ganged up with B today,
that was a mistake.
I thought that was a mistake.
Any ganging up with B is
there was a
mistake.
Hiding of the tea that you have yet to find out about because David unhid it and put it back in your drawer. But they all dogface and B went off to hide your to hide your tea, and it wasn't very nice.
The one we're all ignoring is Rodrigo.
Yes.
The Queen thing was fantastic.
It was.
He's a
it was
decent
great, wasn't
guy,
it?
Loves our country.
Yeah. Just very quickly, I want to ask you something very quickly,
really
Freddie.
Genuine.
Has Big Brother changed you?
Huh?
Has Big Brother changed you?
I'll find
very
out.
Very quickly.
I've grown as a person a lot.
What will the servant say back
John,
at your mansion?
This is my show. Shush.
I've grown a lot. We'll find out.
Listen, Freddie, yes. I think that you have been an all-humming, all-loving, orgasmic, amazing housemate. Honestly, you have. You've been
Thank
so
you.
Entertaining.
Thank you.
Really best trip.
Oh, I've loved it.
It's Freddie!
My biggest fear was that I'd end up taking myself too seriously. There is no danger of that whatsoever.
He's just so genuine, really, really lovely guy.
Your new legal name will be
Half-Wit.
Happy birthday, Half-Wit.
Yes! I love singing.
Freddie, shut up!
Bonkers.
There's definitely people in the house I find sexy.
Hey.
I'm so sexual.
Yeah, it's really, really nice.
If we weren't in the Big Brother house right now, you would be over my shoulder and to the bedroom like that.
You've got too many issues. You over-analyse everything.
The public need to see that you're an arsehole. You are such a little prick.
I have every reason to doubt your honesty.
Oh, my Jesus Christ.
I'm not sure how long I can have being in this house.
Bonkers. This is me. I'm a human.
I look at myself in the mirror now and I see a man. And I see a fighter. That was a really incredible experience.
One thing very, very quickly, out of 10, how do you rate yourself singing?
9.
How would you rate him?
0-.
So, bless you. Yeah, amazing. Anyway, listen, ladies and gentlemen, it's Freddie! Yes! Also to our guests, John McCrerick, Judy James. Listen, Freddie is out, but the fun is still going to continue on Big Mouth with me over on E4 straight after this, and you're coming with me.
All right.
Catch the main show tomorrow night. Let's do it. 9:10 on Channel 4. I can't wait.
The Tuffs are back!
Stole the necklace and stuff on it, making Rock look rock and roll.
I know, I don't know what the hell he was wearing. He looked all feminine.
Yeah, he looked a bit...
My dog wouldn't you? I've got like loads of arms.
Your mum got in that.
I don't know why she put him in that.
Oh, her music.
I want
But look at that crowd now, it does my head in.
I'll show you Army next, because I think when will come out, I don't want him to be now.
I turned the volume down.
Yeah.
No, but it's just constant noise.
Yeah, they'll turn it off. Once that stops.